Don't ever accept when somebody says, can anything be done? Or that you have to live under a certain title, or you have to have a stigma attached to you. That is a lie. And two of those young boys, Joshua and Caleb, absolutely, they are miracles. And how blessed they were to end up in a home with Carol Richardson. God bless you. God bless you. And again, don't be coming down to Georgia without letting us know all this next time. Bring all your machines. Not any different than my saying, I don't know about you, but I know about me. Tonight's my night. That is giving you a point of contact. That's all it's doing. You're setting yourself up as a point of contact. That's what, actually, the handkerchiefs and all of those things are a point of contact. Most of us need a physical point of contact to help us. So if you have a handkerchief or a piece of cloth, or the anointing does not go into Kleenex. So I can prove that. You blow a hole in a Kleenex. But it does not go. But anyway, if you would like to bring a handkerchief or something and lay it up here anywhere on the stage, just come in right now, just do it and let it be up there. If you don't have a handkerchief, or they will open our book table up back there for just a second, and they'll be happy to. You can, in our package, you can get three for $10, or we're sold out. Forget it. Huh? They're bandanas. They're bandanas back there. Well, how much bandanas? Yeah, they're bandanas. You can buy a bandana. Take it and put it on your puppy. Wear it on your head. Put it on your horse. We got big ones. And your cat. Right. But anyway, there may be some red ones back there. I don't know. But whatever there is, just go and get them. Again, any kind of cloth, just as long as it's cloth. Any kind of cloth. I don't know if I've told this story here or not, but while you're coming, I'll tell it. Velda and I were in Canada holding a healing meeting somewhere up there, all the many times we've been. Where were we, Toronto? And it was a large healing meeting, and I made this same kind of statement. Bring your cloth, bring anything, you know, and we will pray over it. Well, by the time the stage was twice the size of this one, and by the time we finished, people started bringing their coats. Ladies started tearing out the lining of their purses. They had never had a healing meeting in that church before. And this is no joke. Bell and I were there. It was stacked so high all the way across the stage that I climbed up on the stage and came on my knees on the back side, and Velda was on the front side, in order for us to lay hands on all of it. I've never seen so much stuff. But we laid hands on every single piece, and guess what? We got reports back. It was amazing what God did. So hallelujah. And people usually ask me this, so I'll go ahead and say it. You cannot wash the anointing out. Now, some of y'all are listening, some aren't. So I'm telling you, I'm answering things for you. Because people will say, well, can I not wash it? If you don't wash it, it's going to be bad news sometimes. You need to. But you don't wash, you cannot remove the anointing. But again, remember, it's got to be cloth. It's got to be cloth. It's got to be cloth. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. My goodness. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. We're counting on strong anointing. Now, if you were not, I want to say something to Helen and thank her. I don't know if she's left or whatever, but I wanted to say that it's been such a joy through the years to come here. There she is. It's been such a joy to come. I love Brother Chris, and it just, I've said this before, for years before I ever came. I came the first time with Sue Curran and took the first part of, last part of her little session or something. I remember that, my friend Sue. But I had wanted to come. I used to talk with Justin Cornwell, telling him, I said, tell him I want to come. I tell Iverna, tell him I want to come. I tell Fuchsia, tell him I want to come. And anyway, so for years I've known about Blue Mountain, for years. And I was so thrilled when I got the opportunity to come. And it's just been a real joy. And you know, Brother Chris just blessed me so much. I just love to hear his stories. I love to. He was a man of great faith. And as you would sit under and hear him talk, I mean, it would just automatically just faith would rise in you. So I want to say again, thank you for allowing us to come. Thank you for letting us be here. We consider it an honor to come. So I thank you. We've seen some outstanding miracles happen here at Blue Mountain. And I'm expecting to see more and more and more and more. Now, let me back up just a minute, and I'm going to continue doing something. Every time I come to do a healing meeting, I never just come and do something I did. I always spend the afternoon praying and asking God, you know that crowd? I don't. What is it they need to hear? I don't think it's fair to come in and just repeat some kind of something. I think you ought to hear the word for the hour, for the moment. And that's what we try to do. And of course, many times, because there's just not that, well, there are a lot of scriptures about healing, but still, if you've been teaching them for years like I have, you're always going to go back and refer to certain things. But as far as I know, and I've done hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of meetings, and I don't think we've ever repeated the exact same message ever again, because God has a way of intertwining it so it will meet your lives. So let's say it together again, because it's very important. I don't know about you, but I know about me. Now I'm going to stop you right now, because I'm looking at you and some of you are talking to me. I want you to talk to your neighbor. I want you to talk to your neighbor. Say, I don't know about you, but I know about me. And tonight is my night. Now, let's be real about this, okay? If you really believe that, you go be excited. Because all you're doing is sitting on go, ready. And, you know, the power of God liable to hit you any minute. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And don't worry about interrupting the meeting. Glory to God. Just let God do his thing. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You know, and don't, you say you go lay hands on people. I have no earthly idea. I'll just go as the Holy Spirit leads me. But one more time, I'm going to watch you now. We'll see who really knows what they know. Turn to somebody and say, I don't know about you, but I know about me. And tonight is my night. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Yeah. Tonight. 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 Whoa. Hallelujah. Woo. The healer's in the house. Glory. His name is Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Ooh, I believe we're ready, Sister Velda. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. I'm waiting for the Lord just to tell me exactly which way to go. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My goodness, we're so ready. My goodness, the pot's about to boil over. Hallelujah. Let me make it clear. I'm not a healer. I cannot heal anyone. So let's get that clear. So don't be trying to touch the hem of my garment. I am not a healer. Jesus is the healer. Touch him. You know, and all I want you to do is fall in love with him. If I can get you to fall in love with him, just fall in love with him, that you will take him for who he is. There's not anything. Don't seek healing, seek the healer. Hallelujah. 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 Now, I'm going to ask this because I already know the answer. How many of you already, since you've been here, this would be your third meeting. How many of you already have experienced healing in your body? Let me see your hands. Let me see them. Glory to God. Okay. All right. That's good. That's good. If only one said it, that's great. Do you understand? Because none of you could heal them, and neither can I. So Jesus is the healer. All right. Well, hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Let me give you some what I call healing truths to try to help you understand some things. I gave you, and you can get that teaching last night, and then you can get Velda's today. It was wonderful. But I talked with you about the essence of healing last night, and I gave you some very fundamental things about healing. Tried to kill some old dead cows and get some religion and tradition, because religion and tradition will make you miss God. And so you got to get things out of your life. Some other things that will make you miss God is that unforgiveness. Unforgiveness. You cannot hold resentment. Because the Bible says, you know, that God forgave us, so we have to forgive everybody else. It says if you want him to forgive you, actually, you have to forgive others. I don't know about you, but I need God's healing grace and God's forgiving power in my life. So to the degree I think that you really are aware, and I say this often, that when you become aware that outside of Jesus you ought to go to hell, sometimes we forget that. It's Jesus and Jesus alone is the reason that we're going to go to heaven. And his forgiving grace in our lives. When you get so excited about what he's done and how he has forgiven you and rebirthed you and gave you a brand new life, it'll be very easy to forgive somebody else. Because you don't want to plug up your forgiving stream. I mean, if God can forgive me, I promise you, for what I know I've done, and I don't need anybody to tell me, I know I should go to hell. But I do know I'm not. Hallelujah. All based on the word of the Lord. And that makes me happy. Hallelujah. And so if you can remember that, then you can begin to let go of grudges. And you can turn loose hurts. And of course, people always say, well, you don't know about my hurts. You don't know what they've done to me. You don't know what I have to live with or what they have to live with or whatever it is. But the deal is, all I know is that the grace of God is sufficient. All I know is that God's forgiving grace can plow through any field. Hallelujah. And I know that when you walk in the love and goodness of God and trust God, God will change anything in your life. If you will spend your time changing you, letting God change you, and whomever it is you're trying to change, give them to the Lord, everything will change. But what most of us do is try to change somebody else, and it won't work. It just will not work. Now, praise is an expression of faith. In order to come to the Lord, I want to remind you that, I mean, come for the healing power to work in your life tonight. I have a teaching back there that talks, why is it working? And some people misunderstand why things don't work in their life. But I want you to understand, you and I block things from God. God does not block you from receiving healing. God is on your side. He's already made the provision. So let me back up and say some things. So many people are here who were not here the other night. So let me state this. We are not here tonight to try to get God to heal us. We've got to get hold of that. And I know a lot of you were saying down inside of you, well, that's why I'm here. No, we're not trying to get poor God to heal us. We're not trying to get God to forgive us. God has already made those provisions. What we are trying to do is to get you to receive what God has given. What God has already given you. Some of you will say that I'm just unworthy. Well, everybody's unworthy. The only worthy person there is Jesus, and he's made you worthy. See, it's what you think about Jesus. I'm going to make this so simple, none of us can miss it. It's what you think about Jesus that really matters. It's what you think about him and what you think about this book. Remember, Jesus and the book are one and the same. This is him talking to us. This is what he wrote us. This is what he told us. This is God talking to us. So whatever you think about the book, it matters more than anything I could possibly say to you. What you think about it. Now, let me say this. What you think about you is related to what you think about what God has done for you. I'm going to say that one to him again. Sometimes we end up being what I call PPP, poor, pitiful person. We end up being a PPP. You don't want to be a PPP. You don't want to be a poor, pitiful person. You don't want to be someone that, well, God won't do this for me, or you don't know what I've lived through, or you don't know what I've gone through, and da, da, da. So that all of life is centered on you. Y'all don't mind if I tell it straight, do you? We won't get anywhere unless I tell it straight. And let me say this to you. If you don't receive it, you won't get it. Okay? So you've got to at least look at what I'm saying and see if it fits you. You can get in some people's presence and I've always said this. I can be in somebody's presence 5 minutes or less, and I can tell you whether or not they're in faith. I've said that forever. Why? All I have to do is listen to you. All I have to do is listen to you. Because you, out of your mouth, life and death come out of your mouth. So all I have to do is listen to what you're saying. You're either blessing your life or cursing your life out of your own mouth. I can tell what you're believing by just listening a few minutes. All I have to do is just listen a few minutes. And usually we end up being a PPP, a poor, pitiful person. You get in some people's presence, and all they can do is talk about them. And matter of fact, you want to tell them, all of us like sympathy sometime. Have you ever met people, you wanted sympathy, something really bad has happened, and you want somebody to sympathize for just a minute? I mean, come on, give me a minute. And they're so busy trying to get you to shut up so they can tell you what's happened to them was worse than what happened to you. They aren't even paying any attention to you. You know what you want to do, don't you? You just want to bap. You know you do. You just want to say, it's my turn. Listen. But you cannot be a PPP and see God's power begin to flow in, through, and upon you. Now, I want to say this. Don't let that bother you. I'm talking louder. You came in here to hear the word of God. You have the ability to focus. Because what we're saying and what we're doing may bring a healing to that child. See? So, don't get annoyed. You have the ability not to get annoyed. You can sit there and say, I drove all the way up there to get my healing, and I couldn't do it because this stupid kid was carrying on, blah, blah, blah. And guess what? It's your fault. Because you have the ability to hear. Because you've got two sets of ears. You got the ear on the outside, and you got the ear on the inside. And it's the one on the inside that counts. Because even if you're deaf on the outside, you can hear on the inside. Hallelujah. Even if you can't see on the outside, you can see on the inside. And seeing on the inside matters far more than seeing on the outside. Hearing with your inner ear matters so much more. than what you hear in the natural. Now, don't misunderstand me. We can pop all of them open, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, through the glory and power of God Almighty. Hallelujah. You do believe that, don't you? All right, hallelujah. All right, let me start from basics. I've done this here. I've done it all over the world, but it works better than anywhere. So here, give me three people. Three people. Real fast. You three right there look good. All right, just stand right here. Face this way. Okay. Everybody's seen this before, but if you paid attention to our programs. Back up a little tad. There you go. Now, Tad, that's Georgia. All right, here we go. If you get this concept, I teach it everywhere I go. If you get this concept, I even did it on TV not too long ago with three little figures. If you will get this, and you can't just get it one time, you got to really understand. Can y'all see? Do y'all know what we're doing? Okay. All of us are three parts. Everybody in here. You are a spirit. You have a soul. Your mind, your will, your emotions, and you live inside of a body. The problem, the reason you're here tonight for healing has nothing to do with the spirit. If you're born again, God Almighty has moved inside of your spirit man. Now let me back up and say this again. You are a spirit. You have a soul. So where do you find that? 1 Corinthians 5 and 1 Thessalonians 5:23. And it talks very clearly. I don't have time to read you all the scriptures, so you can just look them up and try to prove me wrong. That'll be fun. 1 Thessalonians 5:23. It says you will be whole, spirit, soul, and body. So you are a tripartite being. So you are a spirit. Listen carefully. Whether you are born again or not, you are still three parts. Spirits, you are a spirit. That's who you are. You are not flesh. You're not flesh. Talking about you now, the you. I can prove this in a second. How many of you have looked in the mirror and saw what you thought was you and thought, who is that? They said, whoa, they put one of those funny mirrors in my house. And yet you stood there and you knew that that was not you. Talking about looking at the body. You knew it wasn't you. You might not have understood it, but you just, that cannot be me. Has anybody ever been there and done that? Some of you who are getting older like me ought to really be shaking your head. I look in that mirror and say, whoa, who is that? This house needs paint. This house needs jacking up somewhere. Things are falling down. How many of you know what I'm talking about? Oh, y'all are so holy. Come on. I need to tighten up this. Hallelujah. See, the Bible says laughter is good for the soul. See, the Bible says it's medicine to your body. If you can laugh at you, no need to laugh at everybody else. You're funny enough by yourself. Now, here we go. All right. So whether you are born again or not, you will never die. People who are going to hell are not dying. They just go burn forever in hell. I mean, I don't have time to go into all of that, but you go burn in hell if you don't know Jesus. I mean, over and out. That's the truth. That's what the Bible says. And the Bible says that God has never sent anyone to hell. Nor will he. We send ourselves to hell. Hell was not made for us. Praise God. It was not made for man. Hallelujah. Now, when I get born again, when you got born again, the Bible says, I'm quoting, I'm just going to stay with nothing but the Bible, okay? The Bible says that the Holy Spirit moves inside of my born-again spirit man. So that means everybody in here, you are a spirit. So So that when you look in the mirror and you say, well, that's not me because I don't feel I'm 100, but I don't feel 100, you know? And you can ask somebody this question. I used to ask these questions all the time of people who were really old, and now they're asking me. But anyway, the question is, how do you feel? I mean, I know you're 100, but how do you feel? And you know what the answer's always been? I feel like me. I mean, I just feel like me. I just feel like me. That's a very interesting and correct answer. I just feel like me. Because me is here. Me's the spirit. And the Bible says that the spirit man is getting better every single day. The Bible says that the outward man, which is the house, it's going downhill. And I forgot to tell you, you're sick. All right. So the flesh is sick. Now this is one person, you understand. This is one person. When you're born again, the Spirit of God comes inside of your born again. Now, don't forget this part. The Holy Spirit moves inside of you when you're born again. All of the healing power of God came into you the minute you were born again. It was the Holy Spirit who did the healing through Jesus when he walked on the earth. I'm Bible right now. I'm quoting Bible. So the one who is the healer is living inside of every person who's born again. How many born again folks have got in the house? Whoa! So we don't have to go out and hunt the healer. You got him. You may be sick as a dog, but you got him. Now the problem is, it gets hung up right here. Your mind, your will, your emotions. He is not sick. He's sitting back here trying to get to you. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit said, by the stripes of Jesus, you were healed. Hallelujah. I sent my word and healed you. You are healed. I took your sicknesses and your infirmities. I bore them. This is what the Holy Spirit's just shouting inside of you. But if you have not renewed your thinking, if you are blocking out what the Holy Spirit is trying to say. Now, let me help you understand something. The Holy Spirit has got to come through your thinking processes, your thinking. I said thinking, I think. It's got to come through your stinking thinking before it can get to the body. So you are blocking your healing that God already put in you. So what we've got to do tonight, we've got to get you two against one wins. Right now, you've got, if you're sick, don't forget you're sick. Now, if you're sick, what we've got to do right at the moment, being sick, we've got the soul, your mind, your will. This is true for everybody in here. I don't care. Everybody in here, this is true for you. That you've got to get your thinking so that it is not lined up with the body, but that it's lined up with the spirit. Because two against one wins. Right now you've got these two blocking your spirit. Now everything you've ever needed to succeed, to conquer, to overcome, to be victorious, to be I am everything, in whatever God has for you, you got it, honey. You got him in you. That's shouting ground. And most of us, we just take him anywhere. You do know wherever you go, he goes. All them crazy places. You don't sit out in the car while you go in. All them crazy things you're doing, he don't just step over here and y'all go on, I'll come back in you in a little bit. No, he's there. He just is back over here. So like your angel who you have, Everybody has an angel that was assigned to them. That angel does not work unless you use the Word of God. So you got an angel following you around everywhere you go, and he is bored stiff because you have yet to use the Word of God to put him to work. Jesus. Every person has an angel with them that when you were born again came with you, and when you came down here, and when you go to heaven, he will escort you into the presence of God. And that angel works on your behalf when you shoot him full of the Holy Ghost. He responds to the Word of God. But if you don't ever use the Word of God, he's just sitting there. And you over here praying for somebody to help you. And all you have to do, life and death are in the power of the tongue. All you have to do is say, I want to tell you right now, thank you, angel, for helping me out. Glory to God. Anybody ever lost anything and prayed and had the angel get it for you? If you haven't, you're a nut. You need to do it. That angel knows where that stuff is you've lost. I could tell you story after story after story. Look. I said, angel, I do not have time for this. Find that thing for me. And it'll show up right where I've been looking. Anybody had that happen? I'm coming back. It matters to what you believe, what you think. Well, I think my angel's going to find it. I think my angel's going to work on my behalf. So I try to put him to work. Hallelujah. Real good at finding stuff. Glory to God. Real good at protecting you. Real good when that car comes toward you. Real good. Put them to work before you get in that car. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. This is what the problem is. This is the filter. This is the troublemaker. You're still sick. We have not gotten to you yet. Matter of fact, the longer I take, the sicker you're getting. Now, if we can change the way that she thinks, and the Bible says on two different occasions, it makes it very clear in Romans, renew your mind with the word of the Lord. Now, what does that simply mean? Start thinking like God thinks. Now, how can I point to me, God? Because God lives in me. I am the temple of the Holy Spirit. Are you not? So you got God in you. So God's thinking in me. Wisdom, understanding, all God's thinking in me. But I got to get it to my body for it to work. And yet I'm here, and all I'm doing is singing about what the doctor said, what this one said, what the internet said, what the TV said. I'm thinking about what all their books said. I'm thinking about I read all them things on that medicine, and I've got every single one of those symptoms. Because if you read it on the internet, you go get every single one of them. And you go start saying, well, it says this is going to take this long. And you look at your time, you keep up with it, you mark it off on the calendar. Yep, just like they said, this is the day. Whereas you should be laying your hands on your medicine and saying, I will not receive any evil side effects in the name of Jesus. I will not have that. You will do me good and you will not do me evil. And quit cursing your medicine. Glory to God. You got to change the way you think. You got to start thinking, you know, by the stripes of Jesus, I am healed. Now say that with me. I am healed.
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 Who said that? Well, how come you saying something opposite? Well, everybody got real quiet on that one. How many sick people we got in here? Look at everybody. Oh, no, not putting my hand up now. I saw hands on their way up. Whoa! This is a trick question. It was a trick question. Hallelujah. You caught yourself, didn't you? See, we got to change the thinking. You got to get. And then the Bible says, you know, over in Timothy, I think it is, that James says in James that the word of God can save your soul. Okay.
Amen.
Get back in line. So, all right. When you can get the soul, and you can't, God won't do this for you. Because it says the word of God will save your soul. God saved your spirit for you. You don't have the power to do that. What makes you get born again so that you'll live forever and live forever with God, and that you will go to heaven and praise God and never see death, is when you receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You just, somebody told you about him and you receive him. Then God rebirths you. You cannot rebirth yourself. God did that for you. But you and I have to save the soul, because it says what saves the soul, what saves the soul is the word of God. So we have the word of God. So you have got to get your thinking lined up with what the word of God says. Why it's so important to have, to listen. We're living in the age where we all should be so victorious. We're living in the age of all the all those machines, you know, that you can carry it around, your MP3 players and your doodly dads and your, whatever all those things are. You can have the word morning, noon, and night. You can carry preaching with you anywhere. You can turn on Christian television. You can do this. You can do that. There is no excuse. Not today. Not to know what to do. If you get your thinking so that you begin to agree with, you know, I am healed. The Bible says, by the stripes of Jesus, I am healed. Then you can put your hands on her shoulder and your hands on her. Then you can be able to take from here and push that word, because it has to go through the thinking processes. Because the thinking processes is the filter. And you filter things through the soul. And you lose it when it gets to the soul. If all you've been doing is watching TV, internet, blah, 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 blah. If you've been up here all weekend on this wonderful mountain to get away from everything, and all you've done been playing on your little toys, you ain't got away from nothing. You've just come in and cluttered the clean place of God. That was one amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. Do you understand what I mean? I mean, you've just brought the world in with you. Now, if you're listening to the word, if you've got music going, oh, that's a whole different ball game. I'm not saying that. But I'm talking about if all you're doing is playing your little games, and all you're doing is listening to this, and all you're doing is going past all that stuff that can send you to hell. I don't have much time. Y'all know what I'm talking about, right? So you've come to a place where the Lord is so easy. It's like a portal. It's so easy to contact God here. It's so easy to feel the presence of God. Such wonderful worship. It's so easy. You know, not only is it easy to breathe outside, praise God, but it's easy, thank you, Jesus, that we're here together. As we're here encouraging each other. We've come to a place to seek God. We've come to a place to be with God. And yet we bring all our junk that is not God-centered. And when you got free time, you're doing things that's not God-centered. So you're wasting time. I mean, you know what I'm talking about? Amen. Ask the Lord to forgive you. He will. Hallelujah. Here we go. So you get your soulish area clean, and then we can pass on. By the stripes of Jesus, you're healed. And so you will begin to agree with the spirit, two against one wins. And the two of you will stand, and this body must line up with the word of the Lord. It does not have a choice. Thank you, thank you. It does not have a choice. Now, it doesn't mean that it's going to line up instantly. It's how much junk you've had in your mind. You got to clean out. Religion will kill you. Tradition will kill you. You have to go back to just the Bible. Most of us know what our religion and tradition says better than we know what the Bible says. Most of us can quote whatever church we come from, whatever denomination, we can quote what they do more than we can what this Bible does. And then you have a tendency to go, nobody's ever told me that. Nobody's ever said that to me. Maybe you ought to say, I wonder if it's in God's word. Yeah. Just because somebody didn't tell you doesn't mean anything. You go to the word and search the word. Healing belongs to me and to you. Then somebody will come back and say very quickly to me, well, everybody has to die sometimes. That is true. But you don't ever die dead, dead. There is no dead, dead. There is no dead, dead. You can't die dead, dead. It's non-existent. A terrorist can blow you into 50 bits. You're not dead, dead. Your house died. But you didn't die. You're the person inside the house. If you ever get it, it'll change your life. It'll change your life. I'm the person on the inside. You think you're looking at a white female and that God called a white female to preach. No, God is a spirit and the father of spirits. God called me. I'm a spirit. I just happen to live in this house. But I'm made in his image. I'm made in his image. Now we all, come on, you don't have to be bright to figure this out. Look around you. We all cannot be in the image of God. I mean, just look at you. I mean, which one of you really represents him? So I used to wonder about that. That doesn't quite make sense. How can I be in the image of God and you be in the image of God and you be in the image of God and none of us look alike? That's because I was stupid. The Bible says I am a spirit and that God is the father of spirits. So God creates spirits and then he gives a house. The body is a house. He gives a house for the spirit to live in. And when the house wears out, it's a house that dies. Not you. Not you. Then you just step out of the house and keep right on going. You step out of the house and keep on going. Glory to God. You step right out. Everything's falling down. You, whoa, I've been set free. See, that old house has been just dragging you around like this. Because that house is what keeps you here on earth. Now, if you're in here and you hadn't got a house, I need to talk to you. We need to have a conversation. Because you're here illegally. And that means you are a spirit that's been done, happened to something happened to you. Okay. Are you with me? So your house, as you get older, the house may slow down, but the very minute that the house wears out, if you can see your house as just something that's going to eventually wear out, again, patch it up, do what you can. Keep it going. Hallelujah. Patch it. Anything you want to. Don't make me go through all of that again. Do whatever you need to keep it going. But it's not you. It's carrying you. And your house has no right. The sign, your house has no right to tell you when to vacate the house. Your house does not have the right when to tell you to leave. You are a spirit, father of spirits. That's who your father is. Your father can tell you when to leave, but not your dumb house. Because your house is not born again. Your house, the house you now have, you will not live in forever. That's a thank God, praise you, Jesus. I'm quoting Bible. You know why people stare at me? Because they don't know Bible. They don't know Bible. I'm quoting, I have not stepped outside of the Bible one moment. I'm quoting Bible. Paul says, I don't know what I'll look like, but I do know this. I'm going to look like him. I will have a new body. I will look like him, and he's going to look like himself. Now, I don't know how God does that. That's not my problem. All I know is that this house came from the dust. This house is going back to the dust from whence it came. But I'm not this house. I'm getting better. There's not anybody in here, if you're born again, that's not getting better on the inside. And the more you realize it, healing takes place on the inside, and it'll push itself out. So the more you start realizing, hey, I'm doing pretty good on the inside. I'm going to get better and better. And the more you don't give authority to your body. I mean, look at us. We got white houses, brown houses, dark houses, all kind of houses. But it's just a house. It's just a house. I got one color house. She's got another color house. I could walk down the street, drive down any street, and I'd have houses that look different. I'd be a fool to drive up to somebody's house and say, hello, how you doing? If I want to talk to somebody, we'll come inside the house. That just went over your head. God wanted to talk to me, so he came inside and talked to me. God doesn't talk to me out here. God talks to me on the inside. That's why my ears on the inside here and my eyes on the inside here. There's nothing wrong with me on the inside. So we shouldn't make such a to-do over what color the house is. Lord, can you imagine how we could live if we all just grab hold of that? We quit fussing and fighting. It's stupid. We all belong. We are a peculiar people. That's what the Bible says about you. You are no longer, you are not a part. No need to track down your family tree. It has nothing but nuts on it down there somewhere. You can get on that machine, you go find nuts as sure as life. But the deal is this. That's not your family. When you got born again, the Bible says you're a new creation. You're a new race. My bloodline comes through Jesus. Thank you, ma'am. Hallelujah. Glory to God. See, it's just what you think. I'm trying to hit on it. It's what you think. It's what you think. It's what you think. It's what you think. If you just hear the truth, you'll know the truth, and the truth will set you free. You know that you can sit right there and make up your mind. You know, body, I'm sick of you. Get in line with the Word of God. Do you hear me? Because the healing power of God's in me. Knee, you move in Jesus' name. Do you hear me, heart? You work correctly in the name of Jesus. I command you in Jesus. Cancer, you are an intruder. You have no right in my body. Jesus took every sickness and every disease. Dear God, don't you take it. And what do? We go around, pray for me. It says, I've got cancer. No, you don't. You've been labeled that. The Bible says Jesus took it. Matthew 8:17, he bore it. He took it. He took sickness and disease. He took it. So you quit taking it. What I'm saying to you is don't give it a right to stay there. Now, sickness and disease, all of us deal with the crisis of life. Everybody deals with the crisis of life. Sickness and disease will always try to come on everybody. Just don't make it yours. I mean, just when they go in and show you the report, I'm not saying, you know, don't slap your doctor or nothing like that. Thank God for good doctors and nurses. Praise God for good doctors and nurses. Most of us would be dead if they wasn't around. So we believe in good doctors and nurses in the medical field. Thank God for them. Thank God for them. But when you get that bad report, you come out of there and you say, I do not receive that. No, I'm going to lay the word on me. And every day I'm going to take me a pill called the Word of God. Hallelujah. And it's going to push that sickness out of me. And every single day, I'm going to praise God that that medicine, the Word, is working inside of me, working inside of me, working inside of me, working inside of me. And there is no sickness, nor is there any situation that is too far gone. well, this is so far gone. I mean, you know, I told you the other night when we first started the healing center that what we asked for, and I ought to let, actually, what's your name, Sally? I need to let Velda come up and tell you, but I'm not because she won't give me the mic back. So I'm just going to hold it. But anyway, she can tell you so many healings, phenomenal. I mean, people that, I mean, they were more dead than alive. I mean, they were, the families had turned them loose and told them to go. We just told them they couldn't. Hallelujah. And speak the word, speak the word, speak the word, speak the word. Now, everybody, again, you know, we all, if Jesus should tarry, we all are going to die, but not dead, dead. Because no matter how your house may be doing, no matter how the house may be doing, on the inside, the very minute, and don't you ever forget this, the very minute, honey, you may be, your house may be just, it's about ready to be torn down. Matter of fact, you may have some family friends that want to tear it down. Hallelujah. Now, I just said a real truth then. I don't know where that came from. Whoa. All right. You may have some family friends say it's time for them to go on. They will particularly be saying that if you got some money you're thinking about leaving to them. My advice is spend it on yourself and have a good time. Hallelujah. Now, but as your house begins to go down, and that day will come, if your house, just know the very minute that the house falls off, you step out. The only thing keeping you here is your house. Which means this, there's not a person in here, if you believe in heaven, believe you're going to heaven, there's not a person in here who's not trying to get there. But you don't have to get, you don't have to go there sick. Well, you won't go sick. You won't go sick. When I'm saying, don't worry, you won't go to heaven sick. No. There's no sickness in heaven. So let me clear that up. Don't write me. Don't call me. There is no sickness in heaven. Okay. Now, but when the house falls off, if I could just help, if the house is so wretched, I mean, it's so decrepit, it's so whatever, you can hardly even, but the minute the house falls out, you step out. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I mean, everything in you is, whoa. You are really alive. You're really alive. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Some of you ought to get a little happier than you look. Hallelujah. It's real hard to teach people when they look like a sourpuss, so don't look that way. Y'all are doing good. Big smile. Here we go. I'm just cutting up with you. You look good. You look good. At least some of you do. No, you look good. No, you look good. Jesus is coming. Hallelujah. That's right. And we're living in the day and age. See, lots of times when I begin talking like this, the healing power of Francis, the healing power of God is already all over this place. The healing power of God is everywhere. And all God is doing is waiting on somebody to say, I see it. So you don't have to feel it. Healing is not a feeling. Healing is not a feeling. Healing is a knowing. Healing is a knowing. I see that. And you look in the Word and you say, you know, I'm going to make up my mind. I'm going to agree. This is what the Bible says about me. And always expect, when just about the time you make your mind up to believe God, the devil's going to try to spit on you or do something to make it look like you'll change your confession. Don't ever change your confession. Don't ever change your confession. No, you lying devil. I love to remind him to go burn in hell someday. Hallelujah. He is. Are you? I like to ask you, have you read the end of the book? I know your destiny. Hey. Hallelujah. So I read the end of the book. I know where I'm going. I also know where you're going. Glory to God. And then if you think he can't read, read it to him. Hallelujah. This is our book. This is the Word of God. He's not a man that he should lie. He does what he says he'll do. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. All right, I'll close out with this because the Lord's already told me, oh, so many of you healed already. You're just waiting for something to, see, you're waiting for somebody. See, faith produces faith. See, faith produces faith. See, like I know you're healed. Now, it doesn't do me any good to know it. You got to know it. You got to know it. Now, when you know you're healed, then you do something. You begin to do something that you couldn't do before. You begin to do something you couldn't do before. Whatever it is, if it's move your little finger, whatever it is, you begin the process of stepping into what God has given you. You can't just sit there and say, I'm just waiting. No, quit waiting and do it. Begin to move into it. Begin to move into it. Since you will never die, and you won't. You won't ever die. No one will ever die. Since you will never die, that means, and I like this part, you'll never be put in a casket. Ooh, I have claustrophobia. You don't want to be in a casket. You will never be put in the dirt. Never. Never. Now, I know people like to go to cemeteries and visit nothing. I didn't mean to say that quite like that. That just kind of came out. There's no one there. There's no. I know we're doing it out of respect. I understand that. But if they in heaven, I bet they'd lots rather see you saying, "Hey, I'm on my way. Glory to God." You know? Just waiting. Put your flowers out there on the grave. Somebody comes steals them 2 minutes later. Surely you're not one of those who borrows somebody else's flowers, right? I'm not trying to make you not go to the same. I didn't mean that. Help me, Jesus. I think I just heard him say, "You're on your own." No. But just remember, you'll never be put in the dirt. You'll never be there, thank God. So no need to spend all your money on a casket. Get a cheap one. Yeah, I've decided the people who buy the real expensive ones, they're the ones anyway who feel guilty and trying to make everybody else think they really cared. Oh, I am really being bad tonight. Threatening to take the microphone. All right, here we go. But no need to get one of those things that, you know, so worms can't get to you. A vault, no need. Who cares if a worm gets to you after 200 years? A worm, you're not even in there. And listen to this, you don't even go to the funeral. What religion does. I have somebody in my church who is owns the funeral home. She loves it when I get on this. She wants me to shut up. That's what she wants me to do. So you might as well just get a pine box and throw them in there and get it over with. Hallelujah. And simply say, "See you soon." Hallelujah. Because you are not going by the way of the grave. Now, that's Bible. Do you know every single thing I said? I can't find the vault part in the Bible. I have to admit that. But everything I said about stepping out and going straight in and that you will not die, it's Bible. Jesus paid the price. He took the sting out of death. He did it. All you're doing is you came down here. You're living for a little bit of time. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes, you came from heaven, a spirit. You came to earth, and you came out of time into earth. On earth, you ran into time. And while you're on earth, you're in time. And then when time runs out, you're gone. That's Bible. You make decisions while you're down here. Where you go. Children go to heaven. Let me go ahead and answer that. Okay, so hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So the devil does not own you. And you know what the greatest thing you can do to stop the devil? Speak the word of God to him. And praise the Lord. And praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Do you know that you can praise your way into healing? You can praise your way. You can praise your way. And if you don't have the power and the strength to do it yourself, find yourself some people who believe. I mean, they really believe and they won't turn loose. They won't turn loose. They won't turn loose. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. This crowd right over here, stand up a minute. Right in here. Y'all stand up. This crowd right over in here. Stand up. Hallelujah. Don't pay any attention to me. Pay attention to the Lord. Hallelujah. I told you to do that because just the wind of the Spirit just kind of swept through here. Hallelujah. Now, you got to think about what's been said and decide whether you're healed or not. You got to think about it. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Don't look around for something. Don't wait for a feeling. Get a knowing and then like that. Then you just receive. You receive what comes your way. You just receive it, you know, just and you just take it. And you just take it. And take it. And then you praise him. You praise him. You praise him. That's that. All right. Crowd over here, just stand up. Just stand up. Well, I'm going to come right back here because I saw it come right back here. And you know, you just take it. You just take whatever it is and you just. Don't pay attention to me. Pay attention to the Lord. Pay attention to the Lord. Make yourself ready to receive. Get ready to receive. Don't pay any attention to me. You got a chair behind you. Don't worry about it. Hallelujah. Just receive. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now, I want you to begin, everybody in here. I tell you what, sit back down. Everyone in here. If you know that you know that you know that God has touched you and you have received the revelation of who you really are. Now listen carefully to me. That you have received the revelation of who you are. If you've received it and a little light bulb has come on and you came up thinking you were sick and you really do know that I'm not really sick, I've got the healer in me. And my praises will release the healing faster. And then I need to do something. See, this is where people have trouble because we act like being quiet in church is being holy. And that's not true. Matter of fact, if you like real quiet places, you're not going to like heaven. Heaven is not quiet. Holy, 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 holy. You're not going to like heaven. So you need to begin to just praise Him. Not because you're going to be healed, but because you are healed. And then begin to do something you could not do. Begin to do something. Begin to do something. Stand up, walk, bend, move, run. Something you could not do, begin to do it. Begin to do it. Begin to do what you couldn't do. Begin to do what you couldn't do. Just do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Now, I could, listen to me. Now listen to me. I could for sure go around and lay hands on everybody, and all I would do was activate what I've just activated with my mouth. Now, if you're determined for somebody to lay hands on you, you go block receiving this way. But if you'll just say, I thank you, Jesus. Not me. I thank you, Jesus. I'm releasing to you what God is saying to me, that the healing power is here. You cannot sit there and not do anything. Because if you sit there and not do anything, you're saying you're not receiving. So you got to do something. You got to do something. Glory. Hallelujah. 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 Glory. Glory. Glory! Glory! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! All right, I'm going to say this, and I'm going to let you go. I'm going to say this to you. I'm aware that most of us come from churches and places that we don't make a bunch of noise and we don't do anything. And I also understand that there are people in here who would be saying, I am not going to let that woman talk me into doing something that I know I can't do. That's a stupid statement. I'm reminding you what God says you can do. I'm just trying to get you to have enough strength and belief and faith to do something. Begin somewhere. You have to begin somewhere. You have to begin somewhere. You have to begin. You have to begin. Move. Lay hands on yourself. Lay hands on yourself. Lay hands on yourself. Lay hands on you. Lay hands on you. If you have a back problem, begin to move. Begin to move. If you have a hip problem, begin to move. Do something you could not do. Lift your feet. Lift your feet. Bend. Do something. Do something. Lift your hands sky high. Hallelujah. Okay, everybody hang on. Everybody wait. Shh. Everybody a minute. All right. How many people in here can, you can wave at me or do something, cannot put their hands up like this? Just kind of wave at me and let me see it. Okay. Let me see. Okay. You're telling me you can't put your hand all the way up. I'm just asking how many people can't do it. Now, I'm gonna watch you do it. Okay, I'm going to watch you do it. Now, all I'm doing, I have no power except Jesus. Same power you have. If you can't lift your shoulders and your hands up, take your own hand and lay it on your own shoulder for a minute. Because right now I'm talking about being able to lift your arms up. Lay hands on you. Just lay it on there and just gently say, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lay your hands on it. Now, when I say three, there's nothing at all about three. There's no magical, you don't have to go pray for people and say one, two, three. You don't have to do that. Nothing about it. I'm just using it as a connection for you, okay? It's just a connection. I want to show you what you can do when you think you can't do it, okay? Keep your eye on Jesus. Thank him. Thank him. You've already prayed. Thank him. Don't listen to your mind. Don't listen to your mind. Don't listen to your mind. One, two, three. Throw them up. All right, now listen. Here we go. I'm talking about people who could not do that. You could not do it. Don't listen to your mind. Don't listen to what the doctor said. Listen to the inward man right now who's going to empower you in the name of Jesus. And you don't even think about it. Just throw it up. You say, well, it hurt. It don't hurt for a minute. Throw it up because the power of God will totally do something for you. Okay? We're going to do it again. We're going to do it again. Throw your hands up if you were not able to. When I say three, do it. One, two, three. Throw them up. Throw them up. Throw them up. Hallelujah. Now, I did that simple thing to show that you can do that with any part of your body. Any part of your body. Any part of your body. How many of you cannot bend over like that? Can't bend over without a pain. I'm going to say three, and you're going to do it. One, two, three. Bend over. Hallelujah. I'm talking about you couldn't do it, do it. You cannot do it, but you'll do it. Didn't I say you go all the way down? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, how many of you did that who could not do it? Wait. How many of you did that? Who went all the way down and you couldn't do it before? How many of you? I see one. Anybody else? Two. Who else? Who else? There are more than two people in here who can't do that. Okay. I'm going to give you one more chance. You can do it at home. Don't be afraid. Don't let fear. Just do it because the collective anointing is in here. Amen. And the collective anointing around you will make it that you can do it. Here we go. Those of you who are standing around somebody, if you think you can't do it, just do your hand like that. So everybody standing around, you can be praying for you. We're talking about bending over as far as you can bend. One, two, three. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. How we doing? Did we do it? Did we do it? Okay. Take your finger, if you're having problems with your ears, take your finger and put your finger in your ear. Put your finger in your ear. Our fingers. Help me. Put them in your ear. Your fingers in your ear if you're having trouble. When I say three, I want you to pop it out. But right now, talk to yourself. Thank you, Jesus, that I can hear. Thank you, Jesus, that I can hear. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I thank you in the name of Jesus. One, two, three. All right, somebody who's having trouble hearing, somebody talk to them, see if they can hear you. How we doing? Can we hear? Somebody wave at me if you're being able to hear better than you could a while ago. Somebody wave at me. Hallelujah, thank you. Somebody else wave at me if you can hear better. Hallelujah, hallelujah. All right, Hallelujah. We're going to do it one more time. Here we go. One more time. One more time. Here we go. Talk to yourself. Everybody around them. Look at people who's got their hands in their ears. Hallelujah. Look at them. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Go with me. Thank you, Jesus. That I'm healed. I command in the name of Jesus for my ears to pop open in Jesus' name. One, two, three, pop! Hallelujah! 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 All right, let me see. How many of you got a result then? Let me see hands. Wave at me. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13. Hallelujah. That's what I could see. God's in. If it didn't happen to you, not when you go home, do the same thing. Lay your hands on whatever that thing. We just curse cancer right now. We curse it in the name of Jesus. We curse diabetes. We curse heart problems in the name of Jesus. We curse it in Jesus' name. Back problems, kidney problems, heart problems, diabetes. We curse it. Cancer, any other kind of disease. We come against it in the name of the Lord. We call you healed in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. You will live and not die, and give God glory. Hallelujah! 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 Well, glory. Wave at me if God did something for you tonight. Wave at me. Let me see your hands. If God did something for you tonight. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You are a wonderful people. Your God loves you so much. He thinks highly of you. He will visit you on your bed tonight. He's everywhere you go. You got goodness and mercy following you everywhere you go. You got the Holy Ghost inside of you. You got your angel right there by you. Everywhere you go, you got a crowd. Hallelujah. You know, you just need to get happy about Jesus. Just get happy about Jesus. No matter what comes your way, greater is he that's in you than he that is in the world. Hallelujah. Velda, did you pray over him? Hallelujah. Miss Velda prayed over every single thing up here. I hope, how many of y'all will be with us in the morning? Glory to God. Please stop by our, just sit down 1 minute. Let me show you what we have here, because if I don't tell you, you won't know. I hate doing this, but you won't know if I don't tell you. All right. The Making is a single CD, The Making of a Miracle. Reverend Velda did that one. Again, this has gone all over the world. If you've been up here, I've been this forever, 20 years ago, Words of Life for Healing. But again, they play it in nursing homes, they play it in hospitals, they play it everywhere. It's unbelievable. If you just turn this down low, you don't have to hear it. It's supernaturally done. I cannot do it again.
I feel like the Lord wants me to say this. The Lord, I felt like, just spoke to me and said that there's some of you who really struggle with depression, and particularly at night when you try to go to sleep, it's like a spirit of oppression comes over you. And I honestly believe if you will just put this on at night, turn it down low, and let it play, I believe God's going to really minister to you and break that thing off of you in the name of Jesus.
Now, the teaching tonight, I don't have it. They have it. So you have to get it through. I've never done it before, so they got it. Hallelujah. All right. And then this one, why isn't it working? So many people say, why? And this one teaching will tell you why it's not working. God's love, the key that unlocks healing. Reverend Velda did that one. Again, if you will understand spirit, soul, and body, two CDs in here, it will make all the difference in your world. Of course, we go much more in depth about it on there. Conquering Faith. Two CDs in here. Conquering Faith. How many of you got it? Hallelujah. Conquering Faith. More than a conqueror. In this life. You got to be a little crazy, do you know? Let me ask you something. Everybody you remember in the Bible, every single person you remember in the Old Testament, they're a little strange. You know Joshua and Caleb? Who can name the other 10? You only know the people that Gideon's and the Daniels. You only know the ones who Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. You only know ones that, how many, 11, 12 in the boat, one guy got out. You only know the ones that did strange things. That's the only people you know. Stood up on a hill, went toot, toot, and rattled a thing and killed the whole army. Come on. You got to believe something. Prevailing faith. Yes. I'm getting excited. Magnificent word of the Lord. Again, I just think these make wonderful Christmas gifts, any kind of gifts. It's the word of God, and it has in it how to pray that word. Preparation for a Move of God, simple, cheap little book that absolutely will tell you whether you're in hope or faith. You can die in hope. If I were to ask you if you're going to heaven and you said, I hope so, I can assure you, you're not. You have to know so. This helps you know whether you're healed, helps you know whether or not you're really in faith or not. And these two comprehensive principles of healing and miracles are really the teaching manual that we did. More about healing is in this than any other place book you'll ever buy anywhere. It's the book we wrote for Christ for the Nations and their teaching manual. And this is 10 CDs explaining those teaching manuals. And I promise you, you want to go buy them all. What? Okay. We did a prayer and praise rally in Augusta at the Civic Center. We want y'all to follow us and keep up with us. We don't beg you for money. We send out a monthly newsletter, and you can go to our website, sandrakennedy.org, and sign up for it. And we try to just keep you posted where we are and what's going on. But we have just established, Timothy actually and Isabella helped us do this. We went to the Civic Center and did a prayer and praise rally for America and brought all the churches together, and it was unbelievable. From that, we established this, Prayer and Praise USA, join the movement. And it tells you right there how to go to it, prayerandpraiseusa.org. We send out alerts about what's happening in Israel, what's happening all over the world. We send you weekly day things to pray for and using the Bible to guide you how to pray. And then when something happens like Patricia, what's happening down there, we put it up, put it out there for you. And you can get it by going to all the social media places, Facebook, Twitter, whatever those things are. All those flashing things that work. What is it? But we want you, you need to know how to pray. We try to help you. You need to know what's happening across the nation, what's important. We would like you to send to us things that are happening in your area that we can send all over the United States and have everybody praying. So you can do that by simply going to that prayerandpraiseusa.org. And if, again, you'll go to our website and give us your email, and then you can get our email newsletter. We want to have that.
Just with going on with that prayer and praise, in order, it's really simple. You can actually just go to your Facebook and you can just press like, and that will automatically let you know in your news feed. And we're actually asking, we asked our church, if you press share, it actually sends it to like 100 people at the same time. So that share is the same thing as you physically meeting 100 people and giving them a flyer. So pressing like is wonderful, but if you can simply press share, that will do magnificent things for the kingdom of God. So in Pray and Praise USA, we just want to change the conversation from gossip and rumors to praying for one another. So every single time you see something crazy on the internet, or every single time you see some kind of gossip about a celebrity or whatever, pray for that person, and you pray will definitely make a change and change this world.
Amen. Thank you, Timothy. Thank you. Again, I hope you'll watch us on. We're on Daystar. Church Channel, Word Channel, and on Sid Roth's internet thing. So you can watch us. You can go and find out when all that's happening. And if the Lord would lead you to partner with us, $20 a month or whatever, I send you a letter of the events that's going on. I write you a personal letter every month, send you a teaching tape, and try to keep you abreast of what's happening in the world. It's my partners who absolutely pay for the healing center, pay for meetings like this that make us come, that also pay for all the television time. So if the Lord were to lead you to help us, we would be so honored. Thank you for listening. I hope we hadn't bored you tonight. I hope you found God and fallen in love with Him. You're precious. I love you. God bless you. Thank you.